Thank you, Mary. Thank you, Igor. Thank you, guys. All right. Do we have a motion to approve the minutes from the August determination hearing meeting previously distributed electronically?
I'll make that motion.
All right. So moved. Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? None? Hearing none? Motion is carried. Awesome. All right. So the purpose of the determination and certification hearings is in accordance with Commonwealth of Pennsylvania Urban Redevelopment Law of 1945 as amended, and the City of Reading Blighted Property Review Committee Ordinance as amended by Bill 108-2010. The City of Reading is considering if the properties listed on this agenda meet the legal definition of blight by exhibiting one or more of the 12 conditions listed in the Act. As prescribed by the ordinance, the City of Reading's Blighted Property Review Committee, BPRC, is meeting to review the reports of several offices and agencies about the conditions at these properties and decide if the property meets the definition of blight and can be certified as a blighted property. As described in the ordinance, if the property is certified as blighted, the BPRC will issue an order to be mailed to the property owner, which provides the owner with approximately 60 days to rehabilitate the property before eminent domain is considered. All right. And I'm going to hand it over to the solicitor. Off to you, Igor.
Thank you. I don't believe that we have anyone present. Is that correct for the hearing?
Correct.
So we can proceed with the consent agenda.
Did we want to look at that property, or since they didn't come?
I mean, if you can give me a second, I'll pull the pictures up from when we did the determination first, and then I'll pull up the more recent pictures that we just took.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, before we get into the consent agenda too, at our staff meeting, we looked at the last property on the agenda, number 19, 8 Nottingham Court, and Heather suggested that we table that until the May 2023 certification hearing, because the conditions are somewhat improved, and especially the appearance.
Okay.
And also for that one, the owner, we've recently found out is deceased. So the property is being taken care of by a bank. And one of our inspectors has been in contact with them, and they have at least at minimum improved the exterior conditions. Like there's a fence around the property, and it used to be most of it was falling over. And the recent pictures that we've been out there in the last couple of weeks, the fence is fixed, and you know, they've been taking care of the weeds and stuff. So I want to keep it on the radar just to make sure they continue. But I don't think that at this point, the certification it wouldn't really do much because, you know, the owner's deceased and it's being taken care of by a bank. So.
Okay, cool.
All right.
Thanks for the info.
1 second to share my screen here.
Do you want to make sure to table the property?
Yeah, sure. So do we have a motion to table 8 Nottingham Court?
I'll make a motion to table 8 Nottingham Court until the May 2023 meeting.
All right. Is there a second?
I'll second
that. All right. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
Aye.
All right. Opposed? Hearing none. Motion is carried.
Okay, so consent. Well, and here's the 438 South 6th.
All right, so these are the pictures that we took in August of this year for the determination hearing. There's not a whole lot of them, but I mean, as you can see, you know, there's a little bit of trash out front. The backyard was pretty overgrown. And then these are the pictures we took more recently on October 14th. Sorry, October 5th, we took these photos.
That is a cut.
What do you guys think?
And Heather, we're dealing with 436 South, South 6th?
South 8th.
South 8th, okay. And this is the individual that wanted to come in, but has not appeared?
Sorry, it is South 438 South 6th, I'm sorry.
This is for the individual that wanted to come in, but is not present?
Right, right.
Heather, do you mind, just since we're looking at this, putting on the record, the delinquencies that we have, because I'm trying to find it, but it's my stack if you have it ready there.
Sure, give me 1 second. So at the determination, the water was off in the amount of $61-ish. The water is now currently on, and the balance has dropped to a little less than 400. Looks like the gas is still off. And it does have 2 years of unpaid taxes in the amount of $45.91.16.
You have handy the violations, the quality of life violations, and so forth?
So there's 2 work orders, 2 notices of violation, 4 quality of life tickets for trash, 4 quality of life tickets for the weeds, and 1 quality of life ticket for the snow removal. And then it looks like they owe our department about $5,700.
And a notice was, when was notice mailed and the when was the certification?
It was mailed September 12th.
Okay. Did you get anything back?
No.
How about this inspection report that's going all the way back to 2018? Any of this stuff ever addressed?
Is the mic on?
Yeah, I can't hear what he's saying.
Sorry, Heather. The last report I saw from property maintenance is from 2018. Is that the last contact? So
2019 was the last time we were physically in the property, October 28th, and it had failed the inspection at that point. It was then rescheduled a couple of times due to COVID right in the beginning of 2020. We were scheduled to go back October of 2020, but it was a no-show. And it is now currently scheduled actually for October 24th, so just in a few days.
Yeah.
And a no-show. Is there any reason?
I don't know. Did they email you saying that why they couldn't be on or no?
No, they emailed me and thanked me for sending Zoom and they thanked me for sending them Zoom information, and I sent them the agenda and the property packet as well.
All right. Well, do we want to put it as part of the packet agenda, or do we want to single it out and vote on it? I mean, they didn't come in. What do you guys think?
I think we can make it part of the consent agenda, yeah.
If I may suggest, there's been notice, and it's up to you guys, it's just a suggestion, I think can go either way, but since the individual has requested a hearing and so forth and wanted to come in, if I'm going to leave it up to you guys, the board, you can do it either way. It may be suggestible just for
the table.
No, just to vote on it. So it's belt and suspenders. So there's no issues.
Yeah. This one actually was previously tabled.
Okay. Got it. All right. Well,
okay.
When it comes to 438 South 6th Street, due to the findings from the affidavits, is there a motion to certify this property as blighted or to table the property?
I move that we certify this property as blighted.
All right. Do we have a second?
I'll second that.
All right. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Okay, hearing none, motion is carried. Awesome. All right. Now I hand it back to Igor.
And I believe that the rest of the agenda is going to be through consent. So I would move that the remainder of the packet be entered and that we proceed through that. Do you guys need me to read everything, all of the stuff off, or how do you usually do it? I don't remember.
I think just the addresses.
The addresses, very good. So let me go through 730 Bingaman Street, 438 South 6th Street that we already handled as a hearing, 152 Elm Street, McKnight's Cafe, 1353 North 10th Street, 645 South 17th and a half Street, 833 Schuylkill Avenue, 726 Franklin Street, 804 Chestnut Street, 149 Maitland Street, and number 19, 8 Nottingham Court was removed from the agenda.
So real quick vote. The first one that he read off, 730 Bingaman, we actually, I didn't do a packet for that one. That one was previously tabled as well. So they didn't receive notice of this hearing. So that one I'm gonna look at that one again for the next round.
Okay. So we have to remove that from the packet then, right? Okay, good. All right. So due to the findings from city staff, is there a motion to certify these properties as blighted properties or to remove them from the target list?
I'll make the motion to certify these properties as blighted.
All right, is there a second?
I second that.
All right, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing none, motion is carried. All right, is there any business to come before the board? Not at this point.
Just a quick question about 152 Elm Street. They were here for the determination hearing. I'm kind of surprised they're not here. Is there any update to that, or is everything that they testified to not relevant?
She did email me yesterday and state that she would not be able to make it to this hearing, but that was all she said.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much. All right, before we adjourn though, or before there is a motion to adjourn, I have been thinking, I spoke to Linda a little bit about it, but maybe if we can put like a fee, if you may, to the rehab agreement so that we can start generating some revenue. I mean, it'll be something small, but I don't know how everyone feels about that.
I have no problem with that because the staff does have to do some work on that. I don't know how much time it takes. I would allow property maintenance to come up with an idea for a fee, according to how much time it would take to process.
Okay. All right. So, I mean, I don't know. What'll be the next step, Linda? Like, we don't have a fee yet. I know property maintenance will have to look at it, but how would that work?
Well, you know, we don't want to discourage people from doing the rehab agreements.
Right.
So if we do add a fee, it should be something that's minimal, like maybe $25.
Right.
You know, maybe instead of a rehab fee, maybe we ask for a portion of, you know, the fines be a portion to like
the blight. Yeah. That sounds like a good idea.
Yeah, I think.
I'd just like to put out there too that after this whole Reed Street property that fell recently, we are just about finished conducting a sweep of the entire city looking for potential blighted properties. I have 324 of them to look at. So,
we're not going to see anytime soon, I guess.
I mean, yeah, at 324, it's going to take years to certify all of those, but it's a jumping off point. And obviously not necessarily all of those are going to make it to hearings, but we did sweep the whole city. And we did get a bunch of ones that, you know, I have to now leaf through them and figure out which ones are going to be coming up for these hearings. So that's, we've actually been doing that all week.
Wow. All right. So I guess we'll revisit this later then, at a later date. All right.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely don't think that it's necessarily a bad idea, but I do agree with Linda that we don't want to make it too high of a fee that it's going to discourage people from applying for it. It really is not all that much extra work on our part. It actually makes our lives a little easier because for the most part, we're going there less when they're applying for the rehab and being granted a rehab, I guess is the first step. But once we grant that rehab, we're usually there less than we would be for a normal inspection because we're giving them a little more time to get the inspection completed. And I don't know that we really get an overabundance of them that it's causing it to be a problem for us. So, I mean, it's definitely something we can discuss, but again, like I agree with Linda, it shouldn't be an astronomical fee if they want to apply for it. Because usually we do require, if they're requesting a rehab, typically we will require that all of their inspection fees be paid before we'll grant it anyway. So a lot of times we're getting some sort of payment for them getting the rehab anyway.
Okay. Well, either, you know, rehab agreement or a portion of, what was that, Linda, that you said?
Fines.
A portion of the fines. Okay. I mean, I don't know who we'd have to speak to about that, but we'll discuss that at a further meeting. All right, so I'm going to request a motion to adjourn. We have a motion.
Okay, I'll make the motion to adjourn.
All right. All in favor? Seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing none, motion is carried and meeting is adjourned. When is our next meeting?
March. The third Thursday in March. We'll probably, with what Heather has just told us about this blight blitz, we'll probably need a meeting in like January, February to decide how we're gonna handle this.
Sounds like a good idea. Awesome. All right, guys, see you next time.
Okay, Heather, if you don't mind, can you quickly look to see if 660... 660-